So when it comes to strategically investing in the growth of your business, I always believe in strategically investing in the things that are the most likely to grow your business. I've had agents get really, you know, interested in new markets and new neighborhoods and new friend groups and spend money towards different things that were not consistent. And when you're building a business, you're always building upon what you've already built. So if you look at your 50 best clients that are your best sphere of influence, or if you look at a tiny neighborhood or a school that you farm, focusing and spending more money in those specific areas that have already proven to be successful is far more important than investing in a new area. If you can do that gradually, great, but know that you've taken as much as possible and you've increased your conversion rate as high as possible in what is producing for you the greatest results. Investment in the greatest results is always far more important than trying to do something in a different area and risking money. Because right now, more than ever, because we know 2021 is set to be a strong market, investing in what you already know and what's proven results is far more important.
As you now start looking at 2021 and how you're going to spend marketing dollars to maintain and increase your business, the idea of spending strategically is always incredibly important. As a company here, where we spend a lot of money on marketing, we look at every dollar and try to figure out how it's going to be most effective, how it's going to generate the best results for you and for us as a company. You should look at it no differently than that. Especially if you have a more limited budget, you should be focused on spending the money on things that are going to be most effective for your business, what's going to generate the best result, the greatest ROI on your investment. Typically, that's going to be spending money focused on your best referral sources and your closest sphere of influence. Doing things for those people who are most likely to be able to bring business to you is going to be the most effective way for you to spend that money and generate the kind of results that you're looking for. As opposed to sending out 50,000 mailers and hoping that you throw a lot of spaghetti against a wall and something sticks, you're better off going and spending money on individuals, whether it be outreach or a small gift or some kind of show of appreciation for what they've done for you in the past. It will come back to you and generate a lot in return by making that investment.
So there are a few things that are the best bang for the buck. Some of them we're going to be focusing on for the rest of this year. That includes the Lux magazine. It's free. The $5 subscription for Lux magazine, where you can put 50 clients in that, great value. AdWorks, your sphere of influence, obvious. Direct mail, super obvious. If you're not sending a direct mail monthly to your sphere of influence, you need to be doing that, because that should be almost a minimum requirement to being an agent. I would say the other thing you can do, which is one of the best bangs for your buck, is when you know something about your client and interest of theirs, and you buy them a physical magazine subscription with that interest in mind, that will hit them 8-12 times a year at a very low cost. Magazines are very inexpensive. And they know that you thought of them, their interest, and they get reminded by that every single month. That's a grand gesture that might cost you $10. And if you do that for 100 people, those magazines for interest that they have personally, that is something you can do that's very kind, that's even better than direct mail. So give it a try. And also, you get to learn something new about your customers. The more you know about them, the greater opportunity you have to be impactful.
So as you think about your spend, you need to really look at where you're getting the exposure for where you're spending your money. So for example, this is years ago, but when At Properties was smaller and we were just a city company, cranes used to come to us all the time and ask us to advertise, advertise, advertise. The problem we had with investing money in cranes at that time was we were only a city company. And cranes, you were paying for city and suburban exposure. So basically, we were paying sort of double for what we really were getting in terms of return, because all the suburban exposure didn't do nearly as much for us as the city exposure did, because we didn't have any suburban exposure. Now, when we've grown into the suburbs, and now when we look at cranes and a lot of the cranes digital that we've done over the years, it's much more focused around all the markets that we're in. So just make sure you're spending money on the kinds of publications or the kind of digital marketing that's targeting the areas that you focus in, and you're getting the maximum return on your investment.
So what's not in this year, I would say, is Popeyes. Doorbell rings, person comes to the door, they have to find a mask, who the hell's at the door, and you're there. I don't think that's a positive experience. What is in, I think, is sending things to your clients where you are not physically there, which saves you a tremendous amount of time. So I would recommend those things. Sending flowers, sending pies, sending wreaths, sending the elf on the shelf, sending anything to your client that gets delivered with a personal note from you, I would recommend that more than anything over the next 60 days. And if you can reinforce that by sending them something in addition in January and February, if you use the cap gifts, we've got the biscuits coming up in December, we've got masks coming up in January, and we're working on a restaurant card in February. Those types of gifts of acknowledgement to your sphere of influence right now, I would say is one of the greatest investments. Those are in because people receiving gifts, it feels good. Remember, people usually don't get good stuff from other people in their mailbox. If you can provide that, I promise you a great experience for your customer.